In college, I lived on the 26th floor. My view of the Brooklyn Bridge was beautiful. My wait for the elevator in the morning, not so much. I thought that elevator was my friend. I would push a button and it would get me to class on time. But no, this elevator, it had a mind of its own, an algorithm. That's right, elevators run on code. Welcome to Comp Chomp, the only show on the internet where pressing all 102 buttons in the Empire State Building elevator is research, not a social faux pas. That elevator that I was waiting for in New York, it probably works like most grunt elevators do. It knows two things, where it is and where it's going. It gets its current location from sensors, something with light, but it uses buttons to know where it's heading. Lots of buttons. The buttons on every floor and the buttons inside each elevator all hook into one computer brain. That elevator algorithm tells it to go in one direction until it cannot go anymore, and only then can it switch. So yeah, I'm pretty sure that what happened is that I was on that 26th floor pressing down, and that elevator was on floor 25 and heading down, all the way down, which means I had to wait for it to come full circle. That's why they called me Late Jessica. That's not what they called me. They mostly just called me Jessica. All right, but let's say that you're an eccentric bazillionaire. Brazilianaire. It's a rich man from Brazil. And you dream of building a building just way taller than anything in New York. You're gonna need some real elevator brains to pull that off. Which is why that simple elevator algorithm, it was not good enough for mega tower Burj Khalifa in Dubai. Those elevators use a destination dispatch strategy. Now, I should point out that we were not able to dig up too many specifics. Like a lot of things in code, those are proprietary inventions. Secret sauce! We do know that you go to a keypad and you tell the elevator what floor you want to go to. Then the computer thinks about all the elevators it's got and all the calls it's got, meaning where everyone is and where everyone's going, and it tells you which elevator will get you there in the shortest amount of time. It gives you that assignment. You go to that elevator, and when you get in, there may not even be any buttons besides like door close and door open. And door close, that's not even a real button. So you just zip, floor, you're there. Simple. The elevator brain is making decisions as this whole like interconnected system. It is not just quick, every elevator for itself. I don't know what this is. Also, you are not getting grouped with passengers going to like completely different parts of the building. You aren't being grouped by your pickup location, but by your destination. Put me in a box, eh? Floor 127. Seven. This is the future. Less time spent waiting for that elevator, thanks to smellgorithms like these, and all that other fun code you're subscribed for. You are subscribed, right? Anyway, the one downside is probably that you'll have less chance to give your elevator pitch to the suits upstairs. Suits. You guys, I got in so much trouble once for calling some executive suits. It wasn't in an elevator though. Chipe.